You can feel drawn to and also feel rejected by the feminine energy. And why is this? Why is it that you feel drawn to the feminine energy? I mean, the feminine really symbolizes mystery. And because it's so mysterious, we are attracted to this. We are attracted to the mystery, the unknown depths and wisdom that feminine energy symbolizes. So this can be a huge magnet in life, as a symbol, as for yourself, as a transformative energy that in these days many people are looking for. Many people are in search of a more deeper, a more in-depth experience. And that's what the feminine energy provides. It gives insights in your mysterious nature. And that's really beautiful. So you can, for yourself, whether male or female, explore this, because we all deal with practical life and mysterious life. We deal with our inner world and the outer world, where we interact with others. And we all deal with energies that we experience unconsciously, or that we observe, that we have to deal with, that we can't just, you know, shut off. We can't shut off anything, even though you might think that you can shut off things, or things that you notice that make you feel very uncomfortable. The more you try to shut things off, the more it actually affects you. So in the feminine energy really symbolizes the openness, the receptive qualities of just being here, being available to love you, to accept you, to be as you are. So how is it then also possible that you can feel rejected by the feminine energy? What is that? Why would you feel rejected by the feminine energy? Is it because you create an image? Is it because you create a fantasy, a picture about how it should be? How this feminine energy has to be inside of you? How the feminine energy has to be around you with others? You create an idea about femininity, the feminine energy, how it should be, how it looks like, or how it can be. And that is that these ideas are doomed to fail, or they're doomed to fall apart, because they are based on illusions. There is no ultimate feminine perfect picture or the ultimate feminine energy. There is only the feminine energy, or the energy that is somehow missing in your experience. It is here. It is also part of you. It's part of who you are. But you might not experience it. So you start to look for it in others. You start to look for it in someone that speaks about these subjects. You start to look for it in daily life. And then you can, if you really let expectations go, you can have a beautiful experience. You can make connections and exchanges that in the way that you can grow, and that you can recognize that it is so much here, it's so much present. But then you have to allow to let it in. You have to allow to feel and to open, because the feminine energy is an open and intimate energy. It's the intimacy of the moment. It's a loving energy. I know this sounds maybe all a little bit too sweet, and maybe it's really not. It's not the words, but maybe you just have to let that also go. You have to let go the idea of the image, also the image of me, what I'm speaking about. Of course, I'm a woman, so I represent this also this feminine energy. I do realize that. But as you maybe know, when you are connecting with me already for longer, you know that this is also changing. It's never the same. It's always changing. My energy as a person, with my personality, also in my femininity, it's changing. So that is the challenge. That's a challenge in life anyway, to let go of expectations, and instead of the expectations, just see what happens and see that there's possibilities to connect, and also to allow yourself new experiences, to let this experience in, and to start to look at yourself in a different way, to see that you are not just only male or you're only female. This is all part of you. This is just part of your expression. But mostly in this very dualistic world, we get very divided, and mostly the focus is only on one side. So I'm here to let you know that we need to integrate this. We need to integrate both. For me, it's more important sometimes to be more focused on the masculine side, and to be more disciplined, and to be more focused and structured. So that's what I'm trying to do now. I'm trying to be more structured. And it's a challenge. It's a very interesting experience. I think that this never is going to end. And we keep on making new experiences and trying, tasting, exploring all that we are. And every time it's wow, it's amazing, it's shocking, it's scary. The feminine energy is also vulnerability. It's a powerful vulnerability, very powerful. And that can be very scary. Very scary. And in the end, the attraction is all about yourself, or about your experience. And in this experience, you may long for things that symbolize femininity, and disappearing in this, or longing to share this with someone. And these are all beautiful experiences. And then you also may experience in another phase or another level that you find this actually very scary, or you find it very confronting, or maybe you feel rejected, because in a way you might reject yourself. Because that's what we do. We do reject ourselves. There's not really someone that can reject you. So that also includes femininity. Femininity, or females, or women, can't really reject you. It's you. You reject yourself in this. You are not allowing yourself to be vulnerable, to receive. It's a very, very strong talent, it's very strong characteristics of the feminine to be able to receive. And some women also find this hard to allow to be vulnerable, to just allow to be and to stay with your emotions, to stay with your sensations and your thoughts and just your breath. So let it in, try to just accept yourself in that sense, and then connect also with others in this field of openness. It's so beautiful. It's just so beautiful. It's the most beautiful thing there is, to really connect, to let go of expectations, and to see that you are this openness right here, just present. So wishing all this for you, and if you want, I can guide you also in this. You can book a session if you want with me, one-on-one, and we can go and through your ideas about this. We can examine together what's going on for you. Wishing you all a very beautiful day or night, or wherever you are. I see you soon.